friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronic. Today we will learn about resistors. Resistors are one of the most widely used components in electronic circuits. In fact, it is really very hard to imagine any circuit without resistors. The principal job of a resistor in an electronic circuit is to resist, which means to oppose the flow of current. Hence the name resistor. So, a good definition for what is resistor is, a resistor is a passive electrical component which opposes the flow of electric current. The most common symbols for a resistor is a zigzag line as per American standard, and on the right side symbol is as per international standard IEC. Resistors are passive devices. That means they consume or dissipate electric power in an electronic circuit. This property of resistor to oppose the flow of electric current is known as resistance. As we know, the uniform motion of electric charge or electron in a conductor is what we call current. If we connect a resistor between two conductors, some electrons are unable to pass through the resistor. So, we get a reduced current flow. This is the main function of resistor. To reduce flow of current in any particular portion of the circuit, we can classify all materials into two basic categories according to their electrical conductivity, namely conductors and insulators. In terms of resistance, we can say that conductors have low resistance while insulators have much higher resistance. The unit of resistance is ohms and denoted by symbol omega. If 1 volt of voltage applied across a resistor and 1 ampere current is flowing through that resistor, then we can say that the resistance of that resistor is 1 ohm. This resistor is a linear element. It means if we increase or decrease the voltage applied to this resistor, the current that is flowing through it will also increase or decrease. This slope defines the VI characteristics of the resistance. The relationship between current, voltage and resistance is described by Mr. Ohm, a German scientist, in 1827. Ohm's law defines that electrical resistance equals to voltage divided by current. Let us discuss this with one example. If we want to light up a LED with a 9 volts battery, as we know, LED has a specified maximum current of only 30 milliamperes. If we connect them directly, the LED will burn out immediately because the battery will produce much higher current than 30 milliamperes. To prevent this excess current, we have to connect the LED and positive terminal of the battery through a resistor. So, here how much should be the resistance value? Yes, we can calculate this with the help of Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, resistance equals to voltage divided by current, that is 9 volts divided by 30 milliamperes. That comes 300 ohms. Here we have to use 300 ohms resistor to light up this LED. This is how we can calculate resistance for any given circuit. Now let's discuss factors which affect the resistance of a material, like nature of material, length and cross-sectional area. So for any material, the resistance can be given by the expression R equals to rho L by A. We will discuss these factors with some examples. Suppose if you want to transfer the water in the filled tank to an empty container. To do this task, we have connected a pipe between them. But unfortunately, some fibers are mud inside this pipe. So the water will flow through the pipe much slowly. Hence the container will fill slower than normal. The same thing will happen in terms of flow of electric current in materials. It is easier for electricity to flow through some materials like conductors than insulators because of the resistivity of the materials. So the resistance of a material is directly proportional to its resistivity, denoted by Greek letter rho. Now the next factor, length of a material. Here we have used shorter length pipe on the left side and longer length pipe on the right side to transfer water from filled tanks to empty containers. As we know, the container on the left side will fill up faster than the right side because of the higher flow rate of water in the shorter length of pipe. The same thing will happen to the flow of electric current. When you have a longer length of pipe, the free electrons has to travel more distance. So the higher number of obstacles it faces through its path. Therefore, resistance of a material is directly proportional to its length. Next factor, cross-sectional area of material. Here also we have used different sorts of pipes on both sides. The fatter one on the left side and the thinner one on the right side to transfer water. The container on the left side will fill up faster than the right side container because of the higher flow rate of water on a big pipe. The same thing will happen to the flow of electric current. When cross-sectional area of a material increases, there is more space for electrons to travel. So there is lesser amount of obstacles for the current flow. Therefore, resistance of a material is inversely proportional to its cross-sectional area. Hence, for any material, resistance is directly proportional to resistivity and length of that material. And resistance is inversely proportional to cross-sectional area of a material. So we can say that R equals to rho L by A. Commercially, there are different types of resistors available with different sizes and shapes. Now let's see the different characteristics of resistors which we should consider before selecting a particular resistor for particular application. The first one, power rating of resistor. As we know, resistors consumes power. The power rating of a resistor defines the maximum power it can dissipate without overheating and sustaining damage. Suppose if 5 volts is applied across a resistor and 1 ampere current is flowing through it, then the power is dissipating across that resistor is P equals to V into I. That equals to 5 watts. We must use a resistor with a power rating more than 2 to 4 times of the maximum power which is going to dissipate across it. The power rating of any resistor is roughly proportional to its physical size. The bigger the resistor, the higher its power rating. Commercially available resistors have a power rating between 1 by 8 watts to 500 watts. Sometimes manufacturer provides power derating curve. Typically, resistors are rated for a temperature of 70 degrees centigrade. Above this temperature, resistor starts to derate. This means the resistor can be utilized at a reduced power level. This is illustrated by a power derating curve. So, while selecting a particular resistor, we must consider operating conditions or ambient temperature. Now, second parameter is tolerance. It is the percentage of error in the resistor's resistance, or we can say that how much more or less we can expect a resistor's actual measured resistance to be from its stated resistance. Tolerance is printed on resistor, or the fourth or fifth band defines the tolerance. Suppose if a 100 ohm resistor have a tolerance of plus or minus 5%, it means the resistance value in between 105 ohms to 95 ohms. Commercially available resistors have tolerance value between 0.1% to 20%. The smaller the tolerance percent, the higher the precision in resistor. Next parameter, temperature coefficient of resistor, or TCR. It is one of the main used parameters to characterize a resistor. It defines the change in resistance of a resistor with change in ambient temperature. TCR is measured in ppm per degree centigrade. Resistors are available with a TCR that is negative, positive or stable over a certain temperature range. Suppose if a resistor's resistance value is 100 ohms at room temperature or 25 degree centigrade and its TCR is 50 ppm per degree centigrade. If this resistor is operated at 30 degree centigrade, then the value of resistance will become 100.025 ohms. The higher the TCR value, the larger the change in resistance value when operating at higher temperatures. So, we must choose a resistor with lower TCR value for precision applications. Next parameter, frequency response of resistor. Ideally, resistors should act as a pure resistor. But at high frequencies, some resistors also have properties of parasitic inductance and capacitance. Because of this, they can operate only at limited frequencies. The frequency response of a resistor tells us at what frequencies the resistor acts as a pure resistor. So, for higher frequency applications, we should consider this parameter of a resistor. Next one, noise. Electrical noise appears in every resistor because of motion of electrons within the resistor, which generates unwanted AC signals which gets superimposed over primary DC signals. So, while selecting the resistor for low frequency and low noise applications, we must take care of this parameter. Next one, stability. Stability defines the long-term variations of the resistance. The resistance value changes after the long-term usage due to mechanical, electrical and thermal loads. So, basically stability of a resistor defines how stable its resistance value over a period of time. So, these are the different characteristics of resistor we must consider before selecting a resistor. So, that's all about resistors. In my next video, we will discuss about different types of resistors used in electronic circuits. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.